Hi friends. Grouping of the organism into distinct region is called as a tagmosis, as we already discussed. The segments that is defined into regions is called as individual tagma. Like insect, it is having three different tagmas: head, thorax and abdomen. Evolution is finding the root or the origin from where the organism would have emerged. Like when we search for the root of humans or from where the human would have come from, we can find out on the monkeys from where we would have probably evolved. So the insect also likewise been believed to be evolved from worm-like creatures which would have lived on earth before insect. From the worm-like creature, the modern insect would have emerged from that. If we see the worm-like creature or the ancestor of insect, it would have started their evolution into insect from the formation of segmentation in their body. If you see in the first structure, we can see that there are no segments, or the segments started to emerge in the trunk-like flat body. In that, the segmentation start to come. Then after the formation of the segmentation, the individual segments are fused or grouped to form the individual organs or individual tagma, like head and the thorax and the abdomen. So fusion of these individual segments formed our different regions of insects, like head, thorax and abdomen. In this class, let us see the morphological features of head. The segments we are talking about will not be visible to the naked eyes in most of the cases, because the evolutionary history will not show them outside just like that. It is only visible during their embryonic stages. So if we want to study the organization of the original structure, we must get into their embryonic stage. So when we look into the insect embryo, there will be two distinct region in the insect head. The anterior one is called as prosephalon, and the posterior region is called as natocephalon region. Prosephalon is having the major function of producing the appendages like antenna and eyes. In case of the natal region, natal means actually jaw. So jaw is related with the mouth part or the feeding organ. So this natal region is going to produce the various mouth parts like mandibles, maxillae, and we are going to discuss it in the coming part of the class. So the insect head is the first anterior tagma, which is formed by the fusion of the six segments, which is namely ocular, antennary, intercalary, mandibular, maxillary and the labial segments. So if you see, the ocular segments means the vision. Any organ which is related with the vision is known as ocular. So this ocular segments is related with the compound eyes, which is the primary vision organ in insect. The next segment, antennary segment, is related with the formation of the antenna. Mandibulary segment, which produces the mandible or the primary jaw of the insect, which cuts the harder part of the food. And the maxillary, it forms the secondary jaw, which is otherwise called as a secondary jaw, helps in the cutting of the food. And the labial segment, which is known as the lower lip. The upper lip is the labrum, but it is not having individual segments, whereas the labium, it is produced from the labial segment. And the intercalary, which means the insertion or the inserted segment in between the three segments in the middle segment, so it is called as the intercalary segment, which is not having its own appendages. These ocular, antennary and the intercalary segments, they produce the first region, which is known as the prosephalous region, which is related with the sensing of the environment. And the next region, jaw, or the cutting region, where the mouth parts like mandible, maxillae and labium are present. So this is about the formation of head. The head, which is made by the fusion of these primary six segments. The head, the tagma head, is attached with the next tagma or nearby tagma is thorax, right? So the head is attached with the thorax by means of the link, which is called as neck. Like we are having our head attached to our body means of the neck. Likewise, insects, they are attached with their thorax by means of the neck, or otherwise known as cervix, or in other terms scientifically called as foramen magnum. When we see the insect head externally, it is highly sclerotized, which means the hardened structure is there in the head capsule of the insect. The sclerotized or the hardened part is otherwise known as the sclerites. 6 major sclerites, which is laid over the insect head, protecting the major organs, forming the head capsule. The regions between these individual sclerites are known as the sutures, or the connection between these structures, these individual sclerites, is known as sutures. We see here the dorsal part of the head between the two compound eyes. Here we can see the compound eyes. In between the compound eyes, the sclerite present in between the two compound eyes is known as vertex. Vertex means the above part or the anterior part. And the frons, which means the frontal part, like we are having our nose. The frons, it is the facial area or the front area below the vertex, just right below the vertex, which is known as a frons, which is just above the clypeus, which is our next sclerite. The sclerite clypeus, it is the cranial area below the frons, to which the labrum is attached. Labrum is the next mouth part, which is attached to the clypeus. So what is the cranial area? The question comes, what is the cranial area? If you see the head, it is having various appendages like the compound eyes and the simple eyes and the antenna. If we remove all the appendages from the head capsule, the areas left out is known as the cranial area. So the clypeus is the cranial area, which is below the frons, to which the labrum, as we already told, it is upper lip of the insect. And the next sclerite is gyna, which is a lateral cranial area behind the compound eyes. And the next sclerite is the occiput. Occiput means the backside. The backside area of the vertex, here we can see the vertex, the backside area or the behind vertex is the occiput, nearby the neck region. And after occiput, behind the occiput, the sclerite post occiput is present. And in case of some of the beetles, the extra sclerite known as gulla is present. So this is about the sclerites of the insect head. The next one we have to discuss is sutures. The sclerites in the skeletal areas in the head is connected by the sutures. Suture is a Latin word which actually means to join or connect, which clearly defines their function. Sutures are the inward growth of the exoskeleton, otherwise we can call it as a endoskeleton, which also helps in the muscle attachment in the insect head. So there are also different sutures for the connection of these primary sclerites. These sutures are sometimes referred as sulcus too. So sutures and sulcus both are synonymous terms. First suture is the epicranial suture, or otherwise known as ecdysial line, which we already discussed in case of molting, where the initial rupturing of the cuticle happens in the ecdysial line. So this is the epicranial suture, or the ecdysial clivage lining, which is present in the top of the head, which is inverted Y in shape. The terminal area, or the topmost area of this line, is known as the coronal suture, and the lateral lining is known as the frontal suture. This epicranial suture, or the ecdysial suture, is known as the composite suture. Composite means it is having two different regions, as the coronal suture and the lateral frontal sutures. This epicranial suture, it does not bear any internal ridges, or it will not provide any muscle attachment space or the strength to the head. So it is just a line of weakness to help in the molting. And the suture in between the connection between the frons and the clypeus is known as the frontoclypeal suture. This frontoclypeal suture is otherwise known as epistomal suture. Epi means above, and the stomal means the mouth parts. So this frontoclypeal suture is actually present just above the mouth parts. So it is known as the epistomal suture. This epistomal suture actually laterally bears the tentorial pit. About the tentorial pit, we have already discussed. The tentorium means the endoskeleton or the inward growth of the exoskeleton, which is actually to support the internal muscle attachment. In that area where the inward invagination of the exoskeleton happens, that area is marked by, externally marked by the small pits, pit-like appearance, which is called as the tentorial pits. These tentorial areas, they help in the muscle inflection, especially in the mandibular area. As the mandible is the primary organ to cutting down the food, it has to be so strong. It is strengthened by the tentorial pit, which is present between the clypeus and the fronds. Our next suture is the occiput suture. Occiput means the behind head. It is horseshoe-shaped or U-shaped suture, as we can see here. It actually starts from the posterior articulation of the mandibles of either side. Both the arms, after running for a long, they will be joining one another above the occiput foramen, as they will be running along from the posterior margin of the mandible, the primary jaw, about which we are going to talk about in few minutes, and that after they will be joined in the occiput foramen or the opening to the thorax. The head will be opened to the thorax by means of the neck region. This suture actually separates the genal area from the post-genal area of the lateral region of the head, and also it differentiates the vertex from the occiput in the posterior region of the head. Our next suture is the post-occipital suture. After occiput sclerite, the next sclerite followed by the occiput is known as post-occipital sclerite. So in between the occiput and the post-occipital, our suture present there is the post-occipital suture, which is well defined due to the presence of the posterior tentorial pit. Like the anterior tentorial pit helps in the movement of the mandibles, these posterior tentorial pits, they help in the muscle attachment of the thorax, which is the nearby segment. The muscle attachment is helped by these tentorial or the endoskeletons. Post-occipital suture is the only suture which is called as a true suture. As suture means joining of the two segments or the joining of two sclerites, are joining up two different regions. So this post-occipital suture, it clearly defines the joining of the maxillary and the labial segments. The maxillary and the labial segments fusion is denoted by this post-occipital suture. So it is called as the true suture among all the sutures. Likewise, the suture between the frontal and genal area is known as the frontal genal suture. Likewise, the glypio and genal suture present between the clypeus and genal. So in addition to that, there are also other sclerite and sutures like the ocular sclerites. Ocular means the vision part. In insect, the ocular part is the eyes. So surrounded by the compound eyes, the ocular sclerites are there, and the ocular sclerite is separated from the cranial area. The cranial area means the hardened sclerotized part is by the ocular sulcus or the ocular suture. And also likewise, the antenna is surrounded by the antennal sulcus or antennal suture, where the antennal sclerites are present. So this is about various sclerites and sutures in the insect head. In the next class, we will be talking about the insect mouth parts based on their feeding habit. You would have observed different insect having the different kind of mouth parts. It is because the different insects or the different kind of insects, they are having the different kind of feeding habits. Like some of the insects, they will be feeding directly on the leaf, like biting and chewing. And some of the insects, they will be sucking the sap of the plant, just like putting the straw and taking out the juice. So based on these feeding habits, there will be different kind of mouth parts, and we will be discussing more about these things in the next class. Now let us move on to the question part. Question number 1. The head capsule excluding appendages is known as sternum, tergum, cranium or cervix. Question number 2 is, which sclerite lies below the fronts? Gina, occiput, clypeus or labium? Question number 3 is, which suture is not found on the head of the insect? pleural suture, epicranial suture, epistomal suture or frontal suture? Question number 4. Match the followings. That's all about today's class, guys. Comment your answers below and see you in the next class, guys. Until then, bye-bye.